becoming acquainted a little bit with some faces that I don't know, and it's a special treat for me tonight to have my sister here, and Kitty, and I would like to thank Holly, the gallery director, who also teaches here, for those of you that don't know that. And Holly has just been a dream to work with, and we're best buds. I know everyone's best buds with Holly. And her husband, Roger, has done a wonderful job of lighting the show and hanging the show. Okay, well, thank you, Roger, whatever you are. Now, since this is called Hidden Stories, this show, I figured I'd say just a tiny bit about that. But I'll start with telling you a story. When I was a child of 6 or 7, I accompanied my parents to divorce court. At one point, the judge asked me who I wanted to live with, my mom or my dad. And I was shown into a room and given a pen and a piece of paper and asked to think about my answer. When I was ushered back to the judge's chambers, he asked me again. I handed him the drawing of a horse. This exhibition is called Hidden Stories because as I'm working on a piece, there's usually a personal story or a combination of stories informing the form and feeling of a piece. When you're looking at the work on these walls, you're actually listening to me. I was brought up in a world where children were to be seen and not heard. My creative work is an utterance from a place deep inside. It comes from memories, experiences, and feelings. In this place inside of me, there also resides the Holy Spirit, the lighthouse in the storm, the Spirit of Jesus, the Word. My work is bathed in this Spirit. Speaking from this place through my Word is an act of healing. By speaking, I am holding the dove of creativity. Then releasing it to fly and to light wherever it wills. My work is also a ministry. I'm showing you in symbolic ways that I have known suffering. I have also known beauty. I'm sharing both with you in my own way. This is the beginning of connection. A reaching out, touching a shared note between souls. The Lord said, I will not leave you as orphans. It is to this deeply human sense of loss, longing, and abandonment that my work aspires to speak. It also aspires to speak to growth, renewal, and new life. I am eager to answer any questions you might have. Again, thank you all.